Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I wanted to take on a question I get asked because I've got videos that go back almost a decade and a half. And I get emails from people and sometimes a comment on YouTube and they go, man, this video's like 3 days old. Do you still boil hot dogs in water? And it's kind of like, you know, tires are still making them round, hadn't figured out a better way. And so there are things that are different, but I've updated videos since then. And so there's a ton of information to make you just puking sick with the information that I provide out there for free. But some of that information is ever the same. It's going to be the same as long as they, you know, we're still living on planet Earth and physics holds up. It's going to be the same. So it doesn't matter if the video's 10 years old and I'm filming Michael Wood or Colonel Mustard in, you know, Illinois. It doesn't matter because it's the same process. And what you'll end up doing is picking up tips and tricks and little nuggets of information that oftentimes inspire vendors. I know that when I watch stuff, it inspires me, and it may not be the exact same thing. So somebody may say, man, you could do it this way. We always like to put chili on and then mustard. And then you have this bright idea of going, you know what? I could put the chili on the bun and the mustard on the bun and then lay the hot dog on top. Presentation isn't going to be nearly as pretty, but does it matter if it's delicious and it holds all that goo in there and they don't end up with chili down to their elbows? So there's things that do change. Like we've changed on some of the ways we process and do lemonade. We changed some of our marketing tactics. We changed, you know, years ago, I was telling everybody, get online and get you a Facebook and then, you know, sponsor your page and, you know, boost your post and all this. Nowadays, I've got a way to market that doesn't cost a dime. So it's just time. So you just do, you know, spend 10 minutes a day and you'll come out successful. Well, there's lots of stuff in there that you go, dang, I didn't realize. I mean, I've got a video that's probably 13 years old, talks about some secret tricks on getting a commissary. So this past week, let's say 4 or 5 days, this past 4 or 5 days, I've received multiple emails. Ben, one of them, listen to this, one of them said this literally, said, Ben, I've called 70 churches and I can't get a commissary. Nobody will let me. Well, here's what I'll say. Bullcrap. You don't, one, I doubt you did that. Two, if you did do it, I'd like to hear what you're saying to them because I guarantee it's wrong. You're going, hey, please give me, let me use your kitchen for free or something ridiculous. Okay. You're not presenting it correctly. I had this case come up and I recorded it and put it here on YouTube. Had this case come up. I think it was in Texas. Guy told me, can't get a commissary, can't. I've been to 4 or 5 bars. And I said, okay. I said, put your money where your mouth is. What bars did you go to? Who'd you talk to? Well, I don't remember who I talked to, but here's who they were. And I called him. He ain't called him. He didn't call him. Okay. So one bar he called. That was it. That was the only one that he called. And the way he presented it sounded ridiculous. Nobody in their right mind would have let him use their commissary, their kitchen, their commercially licensed kitchen for free or at all the way he presented it. So I ended up getting that guy, that bar that had told him no, I ended up getting that for him for free. And I videoed and I recorded the phone call and everything and got permission to post it. And I posted it. So the point is that there's tons of information on ways to get a commissary, maybe 40 or 50 ways to get a free commissary. One of the biggest obstacles vendors run across is they go, dang, I can't get a commissary. It's scary. I got to ask people questions. And they worry about it. And I understand I was the same way, but you have to do it. And it's a once and done thing. That's what's so nice about this. You do it once and then you're done. It ain't like every day you got to do that same thing again. No. You do it once, kind of like your permit or your license to vend. One time, done, let's move on. And so with everything worth doing comes some obstacles, comes some red tape. You're an entrepreneur, you're business-minded, You are going to make it on your own. You're not beholden to some boss or 16 different supervisors. You're going to make it. Well, go ahead and make that sacrifice to call. I give you the words to say. I tell you how to approach them. I tell you what to do. This is just some of the stuff in those videos that are way old. Well, it doesn't matter. Those are timeless videos. So I will always create more videos, and I'm going to start doing Q&As, okay? But if I've answered it 9 times and you ask it on a Q&A, I'm going to tell you what video it's on, okay? So that's how I do it. Or if I get a lot of people, like the past 4 or 5 days, where a lot of people said, Ben, I can't get a commissary, can't get one. I've tried everywhere. I think I'm going to have to go over to Mars and see, or I'm going to have to build a restaurant just to have a commissary. Nope, nope, nope. It's ridiculous, and nobody has to do that. It's just ridiculous. And there's solutions around it. Let's say you're just petrified to go get a commissary. I know I didn't even start this video off. It's going to be about commissaries. But let's say you're petrified to talk to anybody. Just then buy you a commissary. Rent one. They rent them by the hour, rent them by the day, rent them by the month. Commissaries. Okay? And I even have the link to where you can search it for your city and state. And you just do it, and you pay $500 a month or $250 a month or $3,000 a month, whatever they're charging. You pay it because, God forbid, you have to talk to somebody and ask them a question. And I'm not trying to beat you up, but why start off in the hole? Why start off down here when you can get here? There's a beauty to being forced into things. When I started, I was forced into it. So I didn't have a choice. My kids wanted to eat every single freaking day. Spoiled brats. And so I said, okay, I got to make this work. If this is the hoop I have to jump through, then I'm jumping. How high, how long, and how many hoops? I'm jumping. I'm going to solve the problem. And that's what it comes down to with business and any business. I don't care what business is out there. There's always some negative stuff. There's some hoops to jump through. What's beautiful about this business, I don't know of any other business that is such a low barrier of entry. So it doesn't cost you $100 million to do it. You don't need to, you know, call all your aunts and uncles and sell 3 kidneys. You don't have to do nothing except a little bit of investment, mostly time, little bit of money, and I even show you how to start without money, okay? LearningHotDogs.com/broke, okay? That's where you can find that. And you can start and go and decide 10 months later, I hate this, don't want to ever do it. I want to go back to Walmart. I was a good greeter. I think I was their best. And you can start doing that again or selling Chick-fil-A sandwiches or whatever. It doesn't matter what your position was. If you don't like it, you can get out of it easily. So let's say you spent $5,000 on a cart and all your flags and your banners and your signs, and you just sell it. You know how many people will pay for it? I've got vendors that just buy carts, just buy them, set up a business temporarily, and then sell the business because so many people don't want to do that red tape that takes 24 hours to do. They just don't have the time for it or whatever, or scared to death. And so they'll sell it as a ready-to-go business in a box. And many people do that. You can check that on Craigslist and on Facebook Marketplace. You'll see people doing it because it works, because there are people that are just scared to death to do that. But if you had to sell it, you can sell it and make money, and that was my point in telling you about that. So you can make money selling it and go, okay, that wasn't for me. And I'm glad that it's not for everybody. Okay, it is hard work. It's very little work as far as it's hard work. It's like digging a ditch real hard. You only got to dig a short ditch, but it's going to be hard for that short period of time. That's how vending is. You vend for a short period of time. You make a lot of money. You get paid better than lawyers and doctors doing it. But it's, man, I got to keep up on my records. That's something we're talking tonight about Vendors United. We do a Monday nights and Thursday nights. We do a live Vendors United, which is our private group of vendors. And it's the more serious people that are in it to win it and not kind of just kind of, I might give it a try. These are people serious about it. And so we have a meeting. And tonight we're going over bookkeeping and simple ways to simplify your life. Because as I've told you before, you wear like 900 hats in this business. You're the head hot dog maker. You're the head welcome committee. You're the head business operations, CEO, CFO, whatever the other acronyms are. I don't know them all. But you're in charge of everything. Budgeting, finance, taxes, payroll. You're in charge. Until you go, oh, I could just get this software program. It's going to cost me, oh, that's right, it's nothing a month. And then, and we teach this. And you get that software program, and it does all your books. And then once a year, you go to an accountant. He puts that into done for you. So there is a lot of things you take on in the beginning, but it's all doable, and it's no luck involved. Another great thing about this business, no luck involved. The worst thing that I see that vendors face is they get a bad location. They're at 5th and Main, and it just sucks, man. There ain't even nowhere for anybody to park to come get a hot dog, and they're like, dang, I ain't making it here. Guess what? They didn't just build a McDonald's there, okay? And now they're screwed because they spent $2 million on a building. No, them hot dog carts have wheels, little rolly things, to take your butt down the street to another location. And that's what you do. You find a new location, and you go, dang, nobody even thought of this. I'm at a factory. They have a third shift, and the cafeteria is closed. I'm going to make a fortune. Guess what? I've been there, done that, at a factory. So I'm telling you this because it's all doable. There's no luck. And you can make all this happen. So those old videos are like gold. You take that information, put it in your head, you create your own ideas from that information oftentimes, and you end up being more successful faster. It cuts out learning curves. Like, dang, which hot dog brand should I try? How much sugar should I put in a 32-ounce cup when the ice cubes are this big? Or what if they're tiny ice cubes? All that stuff I've already done for you. It doesn't change. It's like the temperature that ice freezes. It's going to be the same every day. Doesn't change. That video from 45 years ago still is effective and accurate 100% about freezing ice or freezing water to turn it into ice. Same temperature, still works the same. I love you. I'll see you soon. I'm going to start doing weekly Q&As, but also sprinkle some other videos in between based on your questions, comments, stuff. If you have any questions, comments, stuff, send me an email, ben@vendorsunited.com, and I will jump on it as quick as possible. Or I'll do a video and say, hey, I did a video. That's a great question. Hadn't thought of that. And that's what I'll do. I love you. Talk to you later. Bye.